Okay, now I will talk about marriage and preparation for marriage. The first thing I will talk about is the difference between male and female. When you understand the difference between male and female, then you understand why there are so many problems of marriage. Now I want to say that God created the male and female differently. I should say, create them different. They are different. Each have their own strength. But it's after man's sin that these differences can create problems. Before man's sin, the difference was very good. The difference. Even now, if we understand the difference and love each other very much, the difference still would, you know, can be very helpful to the marriage. You can ask this question to come out. It's very important. What I'm saying is very important.
Okay.
Now,
yeah.
The big difference between male and female. The big difference is that male are geared toward action and the, you know, goals.
Abami baga Olivia vayo jagara jagara aba move buli atako yakaonga vayo mufumbiro jetu ogera kumufumbo. I want everybody to come out now, to come here, because they're going to ask questions about marriage.
Okay, you can tell them later they're cooking, it's okay. Okay, men are geared. God created them that they have more interest in action.
Abami boba ato ndi wanga bagara kola bintu.
And goals in action. And then God created women to be mostly interested in relationship and caring for people, feelings, and taking care of family. Now you might say, well, some women work too. But even when they work, they see that the family and the relationship is most important. And women, starting from girls, they all see relationship caring as very important. And also communication. They see communication. And talking about what's in the heart is very important. Now, as a pastor, I greet the people in the church. I notice that sometimes the parents carry a baby girl, maybe 2 years old.
Or maybe
1.5 years old. Now the baby girl are generally very happy to greet the pastor. But when he carries a baby boy to come out, the baby boy may be playing with something and doesn't pay attention to the pastor. We notice a difference even when they are very young. Have you noticed that when you see little baby girls? They like to relate to people. They like interaction. They like care more. And the boys like to play with the, you know, the games and do the things they want to do.
differences.
It's because we are created differently. That's the reason why most of the construction in the world and most businesses were operated by men. Because men want to do things, they want to do things
physically.
And when a group of men talk together, they talk about what they do, they talk about having fun, or they just talk with each other and boast and who is better, whatever.
But
when women talk together, they talk about the people around them. They talk about what they are not happy about. What they worry about. So women pay attention to their feelings. Now I want to say this, when men date and women date, they have different purposes. When men date, when women date, they want to find someone who loves them and cares for them. They see marriage as the beginning of more care. And I want to say that for most men, when they date, it is a job. It's a job. They want to get a girlfriend. After he gets the girlfriend, the job is done. You are mine. And especially for male, the interest is in sex. So after they date someone and they have sex, now I want to say even among Christian men too, unless if the Christian man is really transformed by God, that premarital sex is against the will of God. That he keeps himself holy. If not, I would tell you, 100% of men, when they date, they always think about when I can touch her body, when I can have sex. Now let me ask you, man here, is any man who disagree with me? When you are dating, your natural instinct,
I'm talking about your natural tendency.
Is it to kiss, to hug, to touch, and have sex?
That's right.
Now for men to have sex, it doesn't always mean love. It is an activity. It's an activity of fun. That they can enjoy. Now if the woman thinks that if he has sex with me, he will marry me, she's totally wrong. And you could be very disappointed. He could have sex with a few women at the same time. He might even tell you, I don't know which woman to choose. So when a man dates, the job is to earn the girl and have sex And then he got what he wants. He might not be interested in marriage. And he's after the commitment, he's not so interested to listen anymore. Now in dating, he's interested to listen so to get the heart of the girl. When he's chasing after the girl, if he doesn't listen, he won't have the girl. And also, at that time, the girl talks more freely. The man regards this as more fun, you know, when she talks freely. But as soon as they are dating steadily, the girl will start to ask questions. Why didn't you call me yesterday? Why didn't you talk to me? Why didn't you answer my questions? Tell me more about yourself. And very often the man is not interested to answer these questions. He thinks that this is boring. It's too serious. So what I'm saying is the natural human tendency. Now for the female, they always want a long-term relationship. Generally. When she has a man, she would like the man to care for her and listen to her. And also, women has more emotions inside her, generally. Now men have emotions too. But when men have emotions, very often they don't like to talk about it.
Yes,
they just go to sleep or watch football or play and forget about the emotions. Generally, man doesn't like to talk about it. And in psychology, they call that, they like to hide in a cave. They like to hide in a cave. They like to handle it themselves. They might not like to tell people. But for women, to tell people is solving half of the problem. If someone listens to them, the woman feels much better already. Because when she knows that someone cares about her, then she feels very good. And so if a woman cannot talk about her feelings, it's like a pressure cookware. Do you have pressure cookwares here? Then this cookware, you can lock it and then you cook and then its pressure is very high. When the pressure is high, then it cooks very fast. And then when a woman cannot talk about her feelings, it's like the pressure cookware. She wants to talk about it. And if no one listens to her, she will start to yell. Now that's why the men say, when we were dating, it's all fun. The man is just interested in hugging, kissing, and having fun. At the beginning, the girl doesn't control the guy that much. But when they are steady, then she will ask questions. Where did you go yesterday? Why didn't you come to see me? And then she wants the men to respond. Now, when you know these differences, if you want to build a good marriage, then you know the way. Let me tell you, the wife, you know, I'm speaking to the man now, the wife and also the woman, your husband, is the most important person in your life. If you make that person happy with you, then for your whole lifetime you have a much more peaceful marriage. You have much more support from your spouse, and you enjoy life much more, and you won't be yelled at. But if you don't love the other person, your marriage can be painful. She will yell a lot, and it will make things difficult for you. So you know, to build a good marriage, for men, it's very important for us to learn to listen and respond to feelings. Now, what's the wisdom of God to create men and women different? God has the wisdom so that men would do most of the construction in the world, the businesses in the world. And so that the woman will keep the family. Now, if God created women like men, there is no coherence in the family. The children will not be careful. Now they have looked at the eyes, the pupil of men and women when they look at different pictures. And when a woman or a girl sees a baby, her pupils are wide open. They're happy. So when women see a baby, what? The baby! And for many guys, when they see a baby, so what about a baby? What's special? And then when a guy looks at a girl, a beautiful girl, the pupils are wide open. Or when a man sees games, you know, activity, computer, cell phones,
the computer, amasimu,
then they want the eyes wide open. So the women have more interest in the baby and take care of the family. Without that, the babies will be deserted, no one take care of them. The men might forget how much food I have at home. Some fathers even forget the names of the children.
Hey, God forbid.
Right.
And what they are learning in the school. But the mother remembered this very well.
General. Nezi birthday, basi tujukiza uli kasera. Na ina kasera lila, umako kwa baji gamba, na kati baji kudiramu.
But I say a healthy mother.
Na hiyo kena kumama.
Now there are unhealthy mothers and fathers.
Wale wale mama bali bachibaba, bali
bachibanda.
Bachibanda, bamange.
Unhealthy mothers because they've been hurt so much. They could tone the anger at the children. Okay, now when we know the difference between male and female, it's very important for all men, and actually even women, to learn to listen to people, listen to their feelings, and respond. Now one time I counseled two persons dating. The man said, I don't accept your teaching. I don't want to listen to women. I just want to say what I want to say. I don't want to respond to the feelings. And I want to tell you, if he doesn't want to listen, the marriage will not be strong. If you want to have a good marriage, now even if you've been married for a while already, if you start to listen to your wife and respond to her feelings and care about her and say how much you love her, she will start to change. And you'll have a better marriage after that. Now, for women, what should we do? You know that men don't like to listen that much. Now, every time when I counsel a couple, a married couple, I ask them, how is the marriage? The men generally answer like that. No problem. Everything okay. When I ask the woman, she would say, there's so many things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8,
9, 10.
Because women generally expect more from the relationship. The man says, well, when I go home, there's food to eat. And she goes to bed with me. Everything is okay. The marriage is okay. But the woman said, there are many things we like to discuss. And he doesn't discuss. So every time the woman tried to talk, and the man said, next time, you just take care of that. Do you find this true in many of the marriage or your parents' marriage? Now, there are exceptions. But mostly it's like that. So what should men or women do? You realize the men don't like to listen too much. So when you talk, make it short. But a woman say, if I talk very short, he won't listen. He doesn't listen. So I say 5 times. He doesn't listen. I'll say 10 times.
But
what happens is the more you talk, the more he will turn off. A man has this ability to turn off. You can talk for half an hour. He's thinking about something else. Okay, now, so when that happens, how can we handle it? The woman should guide the man. Now the best is this is done in counseling. In counseling, I will first ask them, Is marriage important? And if your wife is very loving to you, very supportive of you, and you are happy together, do you like that? The man always said, yes, I like that. But she talks too much. She's too emotional. Why is she emotional? Because the husband doesn't listen to her. So what the man can do is to listen and care about her and love her, and she'll be much happier. But still, in Chinese we have this saying. Woman's heart is like a needle in the ocean. It's hard to find it and understand it. Men cannot. It's very hard to understand women's heart. I mean, we are eating normally. Why is she unhappy? So many men didn't understand that. I use an illustration. In a birthday, in a marriage anniversary of a couple, the husband buy a coffee cooker, I forgot the word, but then it's a mixed coffee to the woman.
Coffee maker.
The woman.
The woman was very angry. The man can understand. Why is she angry? Now, I did not see that movie myself. Someone saw it. There could be two reasons. The man liked the coffee. Second reason. That is not a personal gift. The coffee maker is nothing related to the marriage. The woman liked a gift that would show her how much he loves her. So the men find it hard to understand a woman. Now what can a woman do? They can guide the man. Now my wife does this a lot. Let me tell you what most women say. They will say, you don't care about me. You didn't take me out.
They want to take out.
I'm unhappy. I'm angry. But my wife won't say it like that. Because man doesn't like to hear that. When a woman complains, my wife would say it like this. When you ask me to come out, go out, I'm very happy. And I'm happy for the whole day. So she guides me to understand that she's very happy when I take her out. Actually, it's hard for most men to understand. Why does a woman want to go out? He sees me every day at home. I'm at home already. Why do we have to go out? Because the men say, you see me already. But for the woman, when it's just going out, just the two of them, it's more romantic. It's a time he's paying attention to the woman. And it's not just doing something at home.
Sikola chintu waka.
But it's a time to be together to talk.
Yes.
So for the woman, this is very important. For the man, he says, I'm at home, I'm just watching TV, you can sit by me, and you can talk to me. That is not romantic. Because the man is interested in the TV. Not in her. So for men here, if you want to get married, be prepared to love her and listen to her. If you don't want to listen, don't get married. But many men say, I want to have sex, therefore I get married. That's the reason why most men get married. I don't want to listen. What happened is that you have a very unhappy wife. And then for the wife, if you learn the skill of guiding your husband to understand you, instead of nagging him. For instance, now you can say something like this. There is something that made me unhappy. And I want you to listen to me. I like you to listen to me. When you listen to me, it makes me very happy. Then the wife let the husband know. When he listened to the wife, she's very happy. Then the man will start to understand. Now, but for many men in the society, they will say, okay, so you're unhappy. Tell someone else I am not interested. But for Christians, I hope you have this heart. The Bible says, love your wife like Jesus, how Christ loved the church. If you want a happy marriage, listen to her and care about her and do the things she likes. Now, for instance, some husbands would say, wife, do more exercise. Buy your exercise machine. Do exercise. And he bought an exercise machine for the wife. This is my way of loving you. The wife doesn't see that as love. Because the wife is not interested in that. She just sees that as, you're telling me to do exercise, to keep myself slim. Now for the wife to guide the husband. When we are together, taking a walk, I'm very happy. Can we have a time for that? And also say things that makes him happy too. Both persons.
Yes.
Now for me and my wife, we keep saying things that make each other happy. We say, I love you. I care about you. I like you. You are fun to be with. So we say things like that all day long. And in my heart too, I really treasure her. But still I want to say this. Once in a while I still forget her feeling. Because it's still the nature of a man. It's hard for us to understand feelings. And to be so sensitive to her feeling. Now, you know, dogs are very sensitive to smell. Dogs can distinguish smell much more than human can. Women are more sensitive to feelings.
Abakyala bafaayo nnyo ku ngeri gye bawuliramu.
Many times more than men.
Okusingira ddala abaami bo bwe bawulira.
Men are more simple as far as feelings.
Tebatwala nnyo bye bawulira ng'ebikulu.
And are not sensitive.
Tebakifaako nnyo.
So for women,
abakyala,
I encourage you,
bazaamu amaani,
not to be unhappy when your husband doesn't understand your feeling.
Obutawulira nnaku nga omwami we takutegedde.
It's natural for him not to understand.
Kya butonde ye obutakutegeera.
But you guide him to understand.
Naye omuyambako okutegeera.
At the same time, don't accuse him.
Musawa ye muto musajja musango.
Don't say, you don't understand me.
Todana omugambe gwe tontegeera.
But explain it slowly.
Naye ngenyola mpola.
Without anger.
Now
if you are angry, he feels that you are angry with him, and he doesn't want to listen. And also for marriage is like this. Now the relationship at dating is high. Because both persons are interested in each other. And you know, generally they spend more time dating. And they both enjoy it. And there is no responsibility. So they all have fun.
Banyumirwa.
So the feelings are high.
Zibera waguru ziti.
But when they are steady,
naye bagenda mu maaso,
the feeling is generally go down.
Okuwulira bye bawulira bikka wansi.
Because the girl start to ask the guy, where did you go yesterday?
Kubanga omukyala atandika okubuuza omwami, walaze wajjo.
Why didn't you listen to me?
Lwaki tewampuliriza?
Already the man feel unhappy. And the men, many men will say, oh, dear girl is more interested. More interesting. She is more fun than you. Now I found out that you have no fun. Any guy will say that. Because the other girl now doesn't ask him all these questions. But when he's standing with the other girl, he will find that the girl will become like the first girl. Then she will start to nag. The only way to stop this nagging is that the guy will listen to the girl and care about her and make her happy, and the girl will guide him. I have something that hurts me. I will be very happy that you listen to me. Now generally the counselor or pastor can say this to the all the people in the church. If you build up your marriage, you will enjoy marriage much more, and your life can go higher. If your marriage is painful, it's very hard for you to have a joyful life. It's hard for you to serve God. It's hard for you to follow the perfect plan of God. If you want to follow God's perfect plan, you need to work on your marriage too. So listen to your wife and be patient with your husband and guide your husband without temper.
Now,
but it's a characteristic of women. Generally, feelings of emotions are stronger. Easier for wives to be angry. And what the wives can do is try to handle the feelings first before you talk to the husband. And then for the husband to understand the wife, it's easy for her to have negative emotions.
If
both try to love each other and care for each other and listen to each other, there's a better chance the marriage will get better. Let me tell you, there are many times.
Now,
first with my wife, the relationship is always good. But there are still times that I neglected her feelings. And then, you know, and I didn't pay attention to her.
Or
said something that makes her unhappy. Now I never intend to say something to make her unhappy. But because as a man, I'm not as sensitive to feelings. Now for men, my ministry is something else. How I handle my time is something else.
There are
different areas.
And
I noticed for my wife, all these areas are related to her, to the relationship with her. For instance, the wives of our pastors would say that how the husband spent the time in ministry and doing other things
are
related to how much he loves me. So for men, that we cannot understand that. Now there are times that I made my wife unhappy, and what I did was I apologized and I said I will try to pay attention to that next time. And then my wife would accept that, and when she hears that I will work on it and I'm sorry, she will let go. Now that's very wise of her. But many women are not like that. They want to show a lot of anger, hoping that if I have a lot of anger, next time he won't do it. But with a lot of anger, the man will have more and more fear of the wife. So both have to pay attention to this to build up the marriage.
So now I know five with someone's
out. And then the husband can reduce this amount of nagging too.
No money, so we're okay, there's no more.
When he say to the wife, I want to listen to you and calm down and say slowly. Now actually I would say first, if I done something wrong, I'm sorry. And when she's peaceful, tell her this. When you tell me what is bothering you in a calm way, I can understand that better. So tell her ahead of time. Now sometimes when my wife starts to be unhappy, I would try, I would stay with her to listen to her. And you can find out from your husband or wife what they like you to do when they are unhappy. My wife never wants me to walk away when she's unhappy. But some men would think that she's so unhappy, I want to walk away. Okay. Now I just condense your teaching about keeping marriage in a very a short session. Okay, your question you can ask later. Or even when I'm eating, you can ask. Or write down your questions.
Okay.
God bless you all. Now, did you learn something? Do you find it true when you observe your parents? Are they like that? Or when you observe your own marriage, or even when you relate to your sister,
you know,
your friends, you know, the people in the church of opposite sex, you notice that the female qualities are very different from them. Okay, God bless you all. Okay.
Yeah.